It's a couple Jordan 1 retros and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never go stepping. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these black cement threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, out, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever. I'm from the bottom, a little one arrive, but it's part of our culture, you gotta be proud. Where I'm flying with the Air Forces, put that shit on to the day that I die. Nikes over Adidas.
What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, the Retro Wiz Kid, the Shoeologist, and y'all rocking with your boy in the Sneaker Dungeon, y'all. Hope everyone's having a great day. Today, we have some new pickups, you know, some little collector's pieces right here. Then we have some clothing items I'm going to show you guys. And then we're going to talk about the sneakers from yesterday and recap how everything went. So with that being said, we're going to jump into the clothing first, and then we're going to move into these boxes right here. Let's get straight to it. Yay! Coming up first, this right here coming from H&M, just a long sleeve. It's kind of thin, not too heavy, but I figured, hey, this right here is about to be fall time, something I could throw on some black jeans or something and throw on the black Balenciagas, something slight, man, just for like the fall time right here. And as I said, this is not too heavy. This shirt right here was like $24, I think, from H&M, yeah, $24.99, and you can't beat it, man. Always can find some steals and deals at H&M, and this is one of the ones that I picked up last week. Staying with H&M, you know, I had to pull some flannel joints out, man. These right here, you know, they go great. Anything that's bread, as far as Jordans or even with the Yeezy breads coming back. And then right here, we have this one right here in the yellow and black. Any Jordan that has that yellow and black. These flannels right here can be worn numerous different ways. You can actually wear it buttoned up. You can wear it unbuttoned with a shirt underneath it. You can tie it around your waist. You can do what you want with it, man. You can play around with this. And I just figured, like, hey, might as well get both these colors right here. If they had had the blue, I would have picked up the blue and black. But these are the two that I also picked up from H&M, and these were only $24.99 as well. Last pickup from H&M right here, we have some plaid jeans. Now, I ain't really worn none. This is actually my first pair like this, but I figured, you know, throw on a nice little black shirt, maybe just a black t-shirt, you know, something different, not like a regular Hanes or something like that. Put some type of quality to it. Rock these. These, again, can go with the Balenciagas, and because it has, like, that off-white cream, I figured you can wear these with white Balenciagas or black Balenciagas this fall. And, hey, super fire, man. I think these were $29.99 right here. I got the, hey, this is the way I played it. I was like, yo, if they ain't got a size 36, I'm just not gonna get them. It's not meant for me. And it just so happened they had one size 36 on the rack. So, had to grab these right here. And now we're gonna slide into some pickups from Spencer's. Right here, we have the Juice WRLD graphic tee. Finally was able to get one. And this was the last one on the shelf last week when I went into this Spencer's. I was like, dang, man, let me go ahead and grab it. This is the album art right here from the last album that just dropped recently. And pretty cool, man. I'm digging the vibes off of this one. And when I was in there, I was asking them, hey, when y'all gonna get some more? When y'all get some more? They weren't really sure. Then I picked up this one because I had a free shirt. And I was like, tie-dye vibes, super fuego. Y'all already know your boy had to cop it, man. Then today, I was going to put in my Lucky Green raffle, and I was like, yo, let me just slide in Spencer's and see if they got any more of them things. And of course, they did. So I was able to pick up some more of the Juice WRLD shirts today that I've been on the hunt for trying to pick up from Spencer's. So this one right here, pretty dope, man. And like I said, y'all can go check out y'all's local Spencer's. I was online trying to get them and everything, but I like going inside the store to get them because I get a discount on them, and then I also get the hole punches for the t-shirt. And this one right here probably being like my second favorite right here, I was like, yo, gotta get this joint right here, another Juice WRLD joint. And the last Juice WRLD joint, this has like that writing, kind of reminds me of like when Cash Money was taking over for the 99 in the 2000. We got this Juice WRLD shirt right here. Then we got the Ready to Die Notorious B.I.G. album cover. I put this pre-order in a stupid long time ago, but finally got it. Something dope to add to the Funko collection. I might give y'all a Funko collection, man, because I got quite a bit of Funkos. I think I have about 30 of them, but they're mainly like Michael Jordan, you know, Tupac, Biggie, Marilyn Monroe type vibes. You know, rappers, basketball players, stuff like that, man. But mainly I say the most of them that I have are Michael Jordan Funkos. Now that I'm thinking about it, yeah, it is. I started off with just Michael Jordan stuff, then I moved on to like the rappers and stuff like that. And then also some of the things that for TV shows, it just depends, man. It really does. But had to have this one right here, man. RIP Biggie, had to have this joint. Man, I don't even know how many months it took for this either. This is the Travis Scott Fortnite collab right here. You have the Cactus Jack right there on the back of it, and then you have Travis Scott right here on the front. And this comes, it was inside that big box that y'all saw. I've been waiting for this joint probably since like quarantine popped off, man. They said it was gonna take a while for them to ship, but there we have it right there. You have the sicko mode, and then you have the T3500. I didn't even open it. I'm not gonna open it, y'all. I do plan on keeping it, but I just like, you know, I'm gonna leave it in the box, because if I take it out, it's a possibility I could break it or I could lose the little pieces to it. I'm just like, nah, you know what I'm saying? I ain't a kid no more, even though I be buying stuff that kind of resembles stuff that kids would buy. But hey, you know what I'm saying? I was just like, man, I'm gonna leave it in here. Really dope, man. You got the sicko mode, the T3500, and the really cool thing is Travis is actually wearing the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott's. So I thought that, hey, that's a vibe right there. That's pretty dope that they did that. And you can tell that they took their time with crafting the way that they put the tattoos and different things on there. Just small little details that they did. If this should do anything like the last Travis Scott toy figure that they made, if you all don't remember that figure right there, and I want to say that was the first one, I'm not sure though, that one is going for over $1,000. And this one being a dual set and having a better box presentation, you know, I'm just thinking like, man, maybe over time it'll go for crazy. But right now they're going for like $100 and something on StockX when that last time I checked. But I waited forever to get them. Finally got them. I don't plan on getting rid of this one, as I said before, but just a nice little piece to add as you're decorating around the sneaker dungeon and stuff like that, or decorating around your man cave, however you want to do it. But I just figured, hey, this is a nice little piece to put up, decorate the room, make the room look a little bit more different and different vibes, you know what I'm saying? Now let's talk about yesterday's sneaker release, y'all. For the first time in a while, I hit on the sneakers app. So I will probably do an on feet for you guys of the Air Jordan Retro 3. I already did the Varsity Royal review. That was definitely a dope sneaker to me, so I was so happy to be able to hit on the sneakers app and also get that 20% discount. So I ended up paying like $150 something. I could have got them cheaper than that, but I ended up doing the 2-day shipping, so I probably won't get them until Wednesday or Thursday, just because of the fact that Monday is a holiday. I also will be giving you guys a full detail review and on feet of the Air Jordan Retro 4 PSGs. Shout out to my cousin Danny, folks came through. I was able to get those. I had already hit him up and told him, hey, I already knew it was going to be a struggle out here in San Antonio to pick those up, just because we were only getting those PSGs at one store. I don't even think anybody out here got the threes. If I'm not mistaken, nobody got those threes out here. So very limited release for those in this area of San Antonio, Texas. Y'all let me know how you guys did. I will do the full detail review over the PSG 4s and the on feet. I probably, depending if you guys want to see the on feet, because I'm pretty sure a lot of people have already dropped the on feet for the 3s. Probably still unboxing when I get them, but I want to know, if you guys want to see the on foot, I definitely will do the on feet for you guys. And lastly, I want to talk about the membership. So your boy got the membership thing where you can like subscribe to the channel and you can be a monthly, do the monthly subscription thing. Let me know. I'll probably drop a separate video, but in this video, I'm just going to touch on it. I'm planning to do that subscription, and I want to know and get a little feedback how you guys would like to see that. I don't want to do just a little subscription where, you know, you'll get to have a highlight when you comment and stuff like that. I'm thinking about possibly doing, depending on how many people we get that say that they're interested in signing up, and then we do that, I'll probably do like a monthly sneaker giveaway on that end of the channel, at least for the members like that. I'll still do giveaways to everybody else. You know, every month somebody can win something out of that. And I just want to know what you guys think about that. Is that something that y'all might be interested in your boy starting up? But I will let you guys know. I'll keep it posted. I definitely plan on, you know, thinking it over. I've been drawing out some stuff, or writing out some stuff, should I say, to decide whether or how I want to do it or not, and just get some ideas. But it is your boy, the Retro WizKid. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell. Join your boy, the Retro WizKid, and the Sneaker Dungeon family. We on the race to 20,000 subscribers now. Appreciate all the love and support that I continue to get from each and every one of y'all. Y'all can head over to Instagram, follow your boy at the Retro WizKid. Until the next video, y'all, peace, love, and Laguna Beach, and we out this thing. Yeah!
It's a couple Jordan 1 retros, and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never gon' step in. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these black cement threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, L, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever. I'm from the bottom.